We've been talking about Black History Month, stereotypes, and assumptions, and I'd like to continue that conversation. The purpose of today's video is to have you examine whether or not you're making too many assumptions, judgments, and you're putting your spouse into a stereotype category. So I want to also verify that there was something I didn't really talk about a couple days ago, and I started talking about dumb jocks and athletes. And I just want to let you know that I myself am an athlete. I'm a swimmer, and for all my life I've been an athlete, and I have to tell you, many athletes are smart, and adult athletes are often very successful, very goal-oriented. They train, they have schedules, they fit a lot of workout time into an already busy life, and they're just highly competent and effective people. I also find that athletes are happier. So they're not just dumb. You know, in high school you think you have people figured out and you can put them into different categories. I find that you don't find too many unhappy athletes depressed on pharmaceuticals and antidepressants. The dopamine and the sunshine and being outside and working out really gets the brain in top-notch health too, depending on what level of athleticism. Now, have you made friends with people of different cultures, different races, ethnicities? We form friendships with people whom we have things in common, interests. So sometimes we could say that people gravitate towards people who are like them. But I hope that you have a category in your life where you are learning from others, where you may have political differences, cultural differences, and that maybe there's something that bonds you together. And why I mention this is we have a much more interesting world if we can just be open to different people, different situations, and that really helps. It could help stop violence, it could help stop stereotypes, it could help stop racism. It's just nice to have different perspectives in your life. Imagine how boring and how closed of a life you have if you limit yourself to a very small group of people. Now, when it comes to marriage, no matter what your cultural background is or if it's different, you will take a woman, a man who are different backgrounds. You will come together and form a we. I plus I equals we. And there's a lot to negotiate, especially in those first few years of marriage where you're finding your way as a couple. And why I mention this is you are having to take assumptions, differences, and you're having to blend them. And I just thought that this is a similarity to stereotypes in a world of different people. So happy Black History Month. I hope you're having a great day. And until next time, make your marriage great.